Hi there, welcome to Tech Update. In today's video, let's talk about LG Q6. I'll be concentrating on the con side, I mean the disadvantages of having an LG Q6. I have exchanged my previous device, Sony Xperia G3, for this LG Q6. So after using this device for a couple of days, here are my honest thoughts about LG Q6. I've seen many disadvantages in this device. First thing is the display quality. It's a 5.5-inch QHD display with a newer resolution of 18:9 aspect ratio. So although the specs wise it's good, but when I tried playing videos on this device, I see a lot of yellow tint. I'll try to play this video. See, display quality is not that good. It's more dull, the colors are not so vibrant. So this is the first disadvantage, the display quality is not that good. The second one is the camera. If I open up the camera and try to point out at an object, in daylight it's very good, but during night time it's not that good. So it's missing the details, especially during the night time. The front camera is good when compared to the back camera because it is covering more room. I mean, it's wide angle camera. So the second one is the camera quality is not that good as they boasted of. The third thing is the charger. It's not a type C USB charging. It is charging pretty slow. I mean, it's taking around 3 to 4 hours to complete charge this device, and the on-screen time is pretty low. And then the battery is getting drained out in 3 or 4 hours if you continuously use it. The fourth one is the sound quality. I'll try to play one video with a sound.
Love your smartphone. Get mobile antivirus and a lot more only on My Airtel app.
So although the sound is a lot louder, it's missing the details. It's like a general speaker. I mean, the sound is not that clear. So here also LG Q6 failed in impressing the customers. The fifth one is LED sensor. For example, when you get any new notifications, you will see an LED blinking on other smartphones. Here, we don't have any LED sensor. So every time you need to unlock and see whether you have any notifications and all. So it's a tedious task to do. I feel this is the minimum requirement any smartphone should have, an LED sensor, because it's not that you have to unlock your device every time to check the notifications. The other major concern is the heating issue. Whenever you play a game for a certain time, or whenever you use your camera for a couple of minutes, or you watch a video for a couple of minutes, the device is getting heat. I mean, especially in this area. So this device is attracting heat for every small task. Those are all the 5 major disadvantages that I have seen in this device. The display is not great, camera is poor, charging it is taking many hours and discharging in 3 or 4 hours, and sound quality is very poor. There is no LED sensors for notifications and all, and moreover the heat problem. So folks, that's why I'm not recommending this device for anyone. If at all you want to buy anything in this budget, you can go for Nokia 6, because the build quality is good and it has a stock Android running on it, which means pretty smooth experience. And also you can check out Xiaomi MIA1, Moto G5S Plus and Lenovo K8 Note. That's all folks, I hope you enjoyed watching our video. Like this video and subscribe to my channel for more technology videos. Talk to you soon. Thanks.